Okay, we can go through the last laps with the XT. The XT controller, it's connected directly into the core and the NVAC, reacts on the rising or falling edge or both, and you need to select which pin will be or which port will be source for this pin. This means the PAX, PB something, PC something, but you cannot have the PA0 and PB0 in the same time. You need to decide. You configure the pin, you configure which pin will be the source, you configure the XT to react on the rising conflict clutch, and we also configure the NVAC. What we do thus in our hands-on. And then the core is notified and core triggers the interrupt. In the code, we first initialize the NVAC, the XT, the GPIO, and then when the interrupt came, we jump into the handler. Then we called the HL GPIO handler, and this handler carried for us the callback. I only showing the initialization. We have this inside our core. How looks like the interrupt handler and how to call the HL handler. And when on the end, where to define our callback. With two interrupts is the situation very similar. We have the two callbacks, one for the IECO 0, second one for example from the interrupt from the pin 529. We get the interrupt and we calling the same callback. And in this callback, we need to decide need to discover which pin is the source of this interrupt. In this pin 0 or pin 5. Or here in my case is pin 0, pin 5, and pin 6. You can use the if like in our case, or you can use the switch.